Namaskaram to one and all. Welcome to this post-lunch session where we are going to have insight into rural economy, alias farmers economy. The most important thing in today's context, during he introduced me as coming from a family of academicians. Even after going for academics during my grandparents' time, we still, luckily by God's grace, I think we have not come out of the roots. As a farmer's son and also a farmer myself, this session also, Mr. Vadivel, who is a professor in Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, he is going to guide us on how this project on precision farming is being done in Tamil Nadu. Okay. First of all, in the post-lunch session, it should be an interactive session, because people are likely to doze off. So we have arranged also for PowerPoint presentation. Let me introduce our speaker today. Dr. E. Vadivel, PhD, is an eminent scholar and also a real field worker. Most of the professors, they just profess. That's why they are called professors. They don't practice. He also practices in his own home. He is former Dean of Horticulture, Nagarjuna University, former Director of Extension of Education, Nodal Officer, Tamil Nadu Precision Farming Project. Currently, he is the Project Officer of E Extension Center. He has done validation of Panchagavya. Most of us could have heard this. He is the first person who has scientifically validated Panchagavya. Before that, organic agriculture itself meant vermicompost and all these Western organic methods, which are not native to us. And Panchagavya, after its gaining fame, Dr. Vadivel has validated it, and he has written this book, exclusive book, The Theory and Practice of Panchagavya. He has also given it, dedicated it to the nation through our Govigyan Anusandhan Kendram. He has given his the copyright of his book free of cost to Govigyan Anusandhan Kendram. Also, he is a biodynamic farmer. He also specializes in Vedic Homa farming, that is farming by Agnihotra methods. Also, he has conducted an international conference on traditional medicines in 2006 in the university. He also is keenly interested, he is also interested keenly in indigenous knowledge systems. That is, our own native systems, which are also important in implementing organic agriculture in the field. Here, his name is widely known in the field of horticulture and also precision farming. He indigenized the famed Israeli model for Indian conditions, to suit all Indian conditions. Also, he is working on the empowerment of farmers by building farmers' institutions, that is, which are wholly run by the farmers, for the farmers, and just guided and given moral and information inputs by the university. Not just treating them like machines and are just advising them, but also seeing to that their voices are heard. He is also doing his utmost in other native systems also, especially in finding and popularizing, that is rejuvenating the native systems like the Kodagurus of our region, that is Kongu region, and also nowadays in other regions also, which are who are instrumental in preserving and propagating organic agriculture through the ages. Now I welcome Mr. Dr. Vadivel to the ages.
Good evening to all. I think the post lunch session is always very inconvenient. The body is more alert than your mind. So since yesterday morning, various speakers, after the last speaker of this day, they have put data, set up data, strategies, concepts, ideologies onto our mind, and ultimately everyone has got disturbed. Disturbed in the sense how awfully we have lost our cultural values, ethics, and heritage of this country, mighty country. And at the same time, how we have opened up the gates for the Western culture to gain entry into this mighty land in the form of business or something else. So that disturbance, that is what is expected out of these seminars like this, and it will spread and spread fast so that awareness spreads across the country. Now, let me focus on the farmers and issues related to farmers and the economy. So when we review the published information, really one gets confused. Even in the very definition of what is rural, the census group, that body of knowledge, they identify the rural in one set of guidelines, criteria. The Reserve Bank, then tell you another set. NABARD is something else. The Planning Commission is something else. For emergency and corporates, it's very beautifully they have done it. Other than metros, every inch of this land is the rural. You may get surprised if I say with whom I should join with corporates, because the India lives in villages other than metro. That means in the metro it is not. Say, these are all physical classification of what is rural, what is semi-urban, and what is urban. There is a cultural part of it, there is a social part of it, there is an ethnic part of it, there is an emotional part of it. That element is not there the way the rural urban divide could be classified. Say, to make things simple for the non-economists like me, the three sectors, primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. The poor agriculture and related activities, they become primary sector, and the non-farm activity, they are classified into two, that is rural industries and rural services. So the education, schools and colleges, now it has spread into people down into remote villages. The education should be in the hands of the government. The task force should be in the hands of the private, that too under suppressive conditions. What is happening is vice versa. Farmers' family, not only expenses on farm alone comes, the expenses on the education of the child. To get a child, boy or girl, into engineering and medicine, it costs much more than 20 lakhs. It tells on the farm's economy. Next. Say, if you take the percentage of people, mostly it is 60% nearly, 60% farmers and then another 40% non-farmers. Globally, China and India, they are the biggest market for the rest of the world. He is going to be the superpower, there is a full context. After Rudraya the British, how could China develop this blueprint and operate strategies, and how it is getting passed? And how, after Rudraya the British, how we are reconsolidating ourselves is a positive difference. Now China is, major problem is with the senior citizens because of the birth control measures and to be expanded. India's weakness is the youth, power. As far as agriculture is concerned, the youth is opting out of agriculture. That is the main crisis. Today it is laborless, tomorrow it is going to be ownerless. For that condition, that Indian agriculture is being pushed into the past. Say, agriculture, some decades back, maybe the early 60s and 70s, it was the activity of the total community in the village. Several communities with the total self-integrated approach, not only the farmers, the washerman, the all other blacksmith, carpenter, all whole lot of community, they have did one activity, that is agriculture. Today, within a family, one person is undertaking agriculture, the rest of the people are into other avocations. So that is the problem we have been pushed as far as agriculture is concerned. According to the latest census, Tamil Nadu ranks first in the urbanization. So definitely it is a growth center, pulling people from their rural villages and putting it onto manufacturing sector and service sector. Monetarily they are gaining, but ultimate loss is the agriculture. Irreparable loss is to agriculture. Next. Second. MNCs only interest is the rural market, the rural purchase power. The money is pumped from elsewhere, from some manufacturing sector, service sector, the money is earned and then it is put into agriculture and then it is spread. And the middle class family, that sector offers a great scope for the first class to have an eye on our Indian market. But agriculture is concerned. The best of agriculture is one man show for 10,000 hectares. Here, average size of the farm holding is 1.73 hectares for the country, and for Tamil Nadu it is 0.83 hectares. So if the farm size is that much, think of the micro class. All other concerns will cripple agriculture slowly, but the shortage of labor is going to cripple agriculture abruptly. And with the tiny plots and tiny farm size, the mechanization is not possible. When land is not going to be consolidated, the other immediate option is there any possibility to consolidate the people, the farmers, and then consolidate the land, pull the land, and do any kind of participatory farming? That's only other option. In that direction, from the US side, we have taken up some initiatives. The case studies alone I want to highlight. In the year 2000, the Theni farmers, the banana cultivation in Theni, it was purely local. The farmers used to cultivate, and at the end of the crop period, call the local agent, fix the rate, and the fellows will cut only 80% of the bunches, and the last 20% of the bunches they have not cut, they will say some other reason and then reject it, and ultimately the farmers who find it difficult to get back what they have invested on cultivation of the crops. Now, 3,500 small farmers owning 1 acre or 2 acre or 5 acres, we have consolidated and then talked about the supply chain management. Who is your real consumer? And who are all the people involved in the chain who buys your produce, add value, transport, store it, retail it, and in that way, what consumer is paying, you are getting only 20% of it. Rest of the 80% goes to the supply chain, all the partners in the supply chain. That idea you have got into your mind first. Then, instead of 17 varieties, we have consolidated 5 varieties and finally 1 variety in a larger area. For a big business, you need volume and you need uniformity. Unless you do that, you cannot expand your market boundary outside your state. So in that way, 20,000 acres, we have brought it under gene and variety, and we have grown the technology, and now in 1 hectare, 3,000 bunches are possible, out of which hardly 5% of the bunches cannot be used in the number one market. 95% of the bunches, they are more qualified for the international market. Having known about this program, this project, and outcome of this project, the Philippine company came to Theri, started negotiating with those farmers, and the negotiation was a tough negotiation because internationally, the banana is the second best fruit crop that is being traded, the whole of logistics, banana. And the Theri banana, Theri is the fertile crescent of Tamil Nadu. Soil, water, the macroclimate, the microclimate, and the tenacity of the farmers to risk for any new venture, the whole thing combined, it has brought good quality bunches. So now it is being sent to the European market. I don't call it the Theri farmers are exporting. The Philippine company is importing our banana from Theri. So that means the status of the farmers on the other side. Yesterday, few farmers, they protested. They were with me at Coimbatore. Sir, why we should give our banana to the world market when our own market is so light? In Delhi, nowhere you will get a good banana. Nowhere the bananas being cared and transported and packed and delivered and given to the consumer. Our market is so light. Why don't we buy 100 containers, 25 containers, and then get 25 acres of land in between Madura and Agra with the support of the Chief Minister Uttar Pradesh, and also 25 acres in Tamil Nadu near Dindigul. Let the train run between Delhi and Coimbatore. Say, from here we can send our banana, mango, amlas, coconut and whatnot. 10 items we can send it from here. From north, from those farmers directly let us procure and bring it to south. And every train it carries 1,500 metric tons and ultimately per month 9,000 metric tons of produce can be traded between the south and north. And is there any possibility you develop me a concept note, sir? This is the demand from the farmers. Or just for 7 to 8 years, I have been with them. Say, particular investment, we met 3 times the union minister and got it, say, 50% grant and another 25% bank loan. The rest, the partners equity. They are the first company that is being successfully run. Ultimately, the farmer's income has gone up by 1.5 times. Instead of 75,000 to 80,000, now it is nearly 2 lakh per acre. and it is wholly systematized. Like vertical and horizontal integration, the whole thing is systematized. First graph, then first plateau, then particular 1 year holiday for the field. You enrich the soil with green manure, with all organics, and do the rest of the land, and then restore the crop. Now it is 20,000 hectares. In most of time, it is going to get doubled. That is only one cluster in Tamil Nadu. There is every possibility to replicate it in Thoothukudi, in Trichy, and in Sirimugai. The fellows from Philippines, they could not believe their eyes to see the Yelaki Valley, that is Nepu one, in Chennapatti. It is there in 1,000 acres. They are being disposed to the local agents for throw away price, and the local agents they transported to Pune and then sell it. They say the same variety is sold in Japan in the name of Trinova, and in terms of dollar, it is going to bring in a lot of money. So now the next work is they are going to start it at Chennapatti for the selling. So this kind of empowerment alone will save the farmer's economy. No more individual peasant farming. The farmers have to come together in one form or other, participate together, adopt a common package, and attain the volume, attain the uniformity of your produce, upgrade the quality, then buyers will be at your doorsteps. That is the logic, that is the lesson we have learned out of this experiment. Next. Say, next to Coimbatore, around 40 kilometers, there is a place called Pollachi. 100 acres of land belonging to 160 farmers. Around the year, they produce only panthal vegetables, goats. Leopard goat, bottle goat, snake goat, and petal. Only goats. Earlier, the Kerala buyers used to come, and then the farmers will have to beg mercy with those buyers to sell that produce. Now, they have been grouped as a commodity forum and associated themselves with their system, and now, once in 15 days, the rate is fixed by the association president. For the next 15 days, no buyer from Kerala, whether Alapur or Cochin or Trivandrum, they should not talk about the price. The price is being, even now, even today, the price is being fixed by the farmers. So that means our farmers are not so ignorant as we think. Our farmers are not with lion cloth as depicted in many of the publications of national or international culture. Given the proper technology, given the proper direction, they have the capability to organize themselves and rise up to the occasion. Next. And at Ukkala, they have started their own shop. When multinational Reliance Group or federal department source, when they approached, they have given almost 150% price rise. Thing is, while we are giving order, we are giving one bulk order, then why do you want, instead of reducing the price, only want to hike the price? The native wisdom says, what I am selling today to our customers, they are permanent customers, slow and steady, over the years we have built up, both in Kerala and Tamil Nadu, that market is steady. You will come today, tomorrow you will change your produce and then opt out for some other crop or some other produce, maybe non-agribusiness produce, and you will go away. If I invest on structure, on technology, on production, just like bubble, if you vanish, then I will have to suffer. So for one time buyer, the rate is higher. For a regular buyer, we offer the same rate. I don't think any of the business schools teach this kind of negotiation. Next to Palani, it is a small village, predominantly with SC farmers. We have started working with them in 2004-06. The guavas they used to harvest and take it to Vatanathra market. They used to run after the buyers for a price of 10 rupees a basket. So that was the pathetic situation. Then, what we have done? We don't want 200 fruits in a tree. We want 50 fruits, holistically uniform and toxin free. What you get out of 200 fruits, you are able to get with this 50 fruits. That way, the technologies were introduced, pinching, coughing, other management issues, but collectively, we will not work with individual farmer. In that village, 250 farmers will come together, sit together, associate yourself, get registered, and then you will come out. In that platform, when we operate, there won't be any problem with the society. Social capital is so notorious. Instead of an association platform, if you go and join with an individual, you will have a phone call with so many other people. Internally, they will generate problems. If you go to the association platform, then that kind of problems you can avoid. Now, at present, what is happening? The fruits are being harvested and then foam jacketed like frosted in apple and it is just delivered on the roadside of the highway. From the roadside, Magesh Exports, an exporting company from Pollachi, they collect, they come there to the spot and collect and then repackage at Pollachi. Then by 8:30 it is being repackaged. Now the price has gone up from 10 rupees a kg to 30 rupees a kg. So that means if we teach our farmers to come together and do it as a group and add a quality to our produce and then make it as a larger volume, the business is yours. If you do it otherwise, then you are after the business. That's great. Say, without university's intervention, without government's intervention, without anybody's intervention, the farmer's own initiative. Satyamangalam is a belt of jasmine. Jasmine is being daily packed and sent to UK, USA, Mumbai, Dubai in bulk quantities. In nearly 3,000 to 4,000 acres are there. I discussed with that senior fellow, how come you got this idea? How you have organized yourself by this? The thing is, the price is being again fixed by the president. You will have three cell phones, four or five cell phones, you will ask, first you will assess the demand. Hyderabad, how many bags? Mumbai, how many bags? Dubai, how many bags? Then we talk to Arab sir that he fixes the price, not the buyer. No, I am not the buyer. The simple reason, the Mysore buyers have insulted their senior farmer at Satyamangala and his produce was abandoned one day. They have given support for the big farmers. That senior farmer took it as a challenge and organized and he started collecting flowers from all the small farmers and taking it to Mysore and selling it. That was how it started. Now it's a strongest association. 85 lakhs daily they trade. The jasmine you cannot harvest it at one stop. It's labor intensive. Even if it is 25 kilos, 5 times it will have to be harvested and then bring it to 7:30 first lot, 9:30 second lot, 11:30 third lot. So that is how it comes. So the thing is, here again, the farmers, unorganized farmers, they have come together for the simple fact that only when they join they can get to the market. If they don't join and start operating dispersely, they are losers. So that lesson they have learned and still they are. Now they are looking for why flowers? Why not jasmine concrete? Why not we change our variety? Why not jasmine essence? So in terms of quantity, it is less. In terms of value, it is 100 times more. So that is how they think. Till this far, they have not resorted to any help from any bank or government or it is possible. Every day, all 365 days, you can witness this auction happening. 35 years old, Peter. It is a news for the university. And we are touching for such lunches. 35 years, Albert Chandrapati Beatty, they used to conduct all big orders across the country. They take, they give support, input, technology to the rest of the farmers, and then collectively they do research. So that is how they have got their own buildings. A very beautiful example of empowerment of women. Barangur Settlement Tract, where the tribals used to raise only rahi. The economics of rahi, the economics of paddy is itself is not remunerative. Paddy and poverty goes together. Think of rahi, final numbers. That is how they are not able to sustain their climate system. Then the minor of Calicut, Gobi, they have introduced rosemary. 5 cents, 10 cents. Then the ladies used to grow instead of rahi, and then collectively they were selling only the herbage. Then the district administration, they have given 7.5 lakh worth the distillation unit to take the rosemary oil. Herbage selling is one thing. If you sell it as a value added form in the form of rose oil, the income was 5 times more. Then from the university side, we have given the tunnel drying system. Because the rice is based on the corn base, it was not, herbage was not able to dry. Now, with the tunnel system of drying, the greenness of the herbage is maintained. The oil quality has come to the international standards. Now, the ITC and the Hindustan Livers are competing to get the oil quality. It is used for everyone to see any time of the year. It is a kind of component of the women. Mango, number one crop for India, number one crop for Tamil Nadu, 1.25 lakh hectares we have. Totally unorganized. They don't come together, they don't see eye to eye. Kochamballi farmers, they will not honor Telugasi farmers. In 16 districts, we have made them to get associated with a district level association, and we got it as a state of federation. Now we have brought the nearly 5,000 farmers into this institutional mechanism. Now it goes as contract mangoes, fully packed form. Now they are able to reach Delhi, they are able to reach Trivandrum, both ends, and they get very good price. And the production system has gone up. Now they are thinking of Jain Gap or Europe Gap for the field to get certified. If Europe Gap certification is there, the price is nearly 7 times more. But why a Europe Gap? Why not an Indian Gap? That's what Abhidhar was proposing. And the Jain, we had a discussion with the Jain people. You have pulp unit, you have requirement, you introduce some Indian standards, we give the Indian standards, these are all the things, if it is available, if it is implemented, we are form, we declare it as Indian Gap or Jain Gap. Who does practice gap means? So that is how they are getting ready for upgrading the quality of the produce and getting into the total country's market. Grapes. Unlike the Maharashtra farmers, in Tamil Nadu, we are able to produce grapes throughout the year. Nowhere in India is possible. We have that peculiar climatic conditions, peculiar heat units, required during that time, required during right time, and we get 5 crops in a year that nowhere else. So this Kampa Valley producer company, they have joined together, and now they are only nascent, just 6 months old. Now they are preparing to go for a packing yard at their place. And for them, we have proven one logic. The city is one major market. If you want to put your establishment there, cost is sky high. Instead, you consider the four-lane roads as the extended city. So much of people are on the road as that of the city. So in all the city, all the four-lane roads of this country, your branded grapes should go and you should directly sell it to the consumer. That means nearly 80% of what consumers pay, you are likely to get. So that is how they have taken to this Buddhism. See, in the year 2006, Government of India has given this provision. They have amended the Company Act under 12A, they say, and allowed the primary producers allowed to join and incorporate a company. In a private limited company, more than 50 people cannot be the shareholder. But here, any number, the number is top capital. And you cannot list it in the stock exchange. But functionally, it is a limited company. There is a board of directors. There is a monthly meeting. There is a CEO. What MNC follows, what a national company follows, the same logic rules they follow. They have an auditor, they have a company secretary, and they follow all. Thing is, there are social errors, there are human errors. In every 100, there are 10 people to go against the logic, against the interest of the institution, and then the whole thing. That is how our cooperative system suffered, and rest of the institutional system suffered. But in this system, the problems are minimal. Small groups of farmers or huge shareholders cannot do anything against the interest of the company. So this platform is exclusively meant for the farmers or any primary producers. They alone can become the members, not the other. So they have incorporated this one. Next. The Israel fellows, they have offered 17.5 crores for a project called Precision Farming. It was a competitive bid, and we have offered 7.2 crores for the same thing. That's 1,000 acres. We will have to give a total state demo for the farmers by doubling the productivity. On the day of signing the MOU, the Israel fellows were challenging the Secretary of Agriculture that the academicians will not complete the project. By next March, we will have to complete. The first thing what I did was, with lungi and soiled clothes, five of us entered into Kuppam. There they have implemented the Kuppam 1 model, Kuppam 2 model, Kuppam 3 model, and assessed the strength and weaknesses. The farmer empowerment was not there. So let us go with farmer's empowerment through as a first level associations. They have used 120-150 HP machineries. We have used our own 45 HP Indian mass production and our own. And the actual cost was 1.5 lakhs and another 3.5 lakhs, it is a consultancy charges. That is the Israel mentor. Each word they will charge. They will not do the whole thing together. First they will give a bit, then they will drop you in, and for the second you are compelled to offer the higher rate. Then the third time, the third installment, still more. So that is the logic. We have driven the surplus out of the sea. Now it has been scaled up to 70,000 acres across the state, in Kerala, Karnataka, even in Meghalaya, this program was taken up. Ultimately, the farmers have been taught individual peace and farming. You are a sure success in the field, but a sure failure in the market. If you want to be successful both that field as well as the market, you will have to come united. Come in the form of any association or producer company or a commodity group. You come together, act on a common platform, have a common technology. In the particular week, the sowing land will be taken up. The responsibility is with individuals. The particular week, the meeting will have to be taken. So that is how we have organized. Now, they have incorporated 7 producer companies and limited companies. Say the annual general body meeting, it is a corporate word. Now the farmers are used to it. First AGM, second AGM, how to discuss, how to develop concept, then how to discuss, how to manage it, how to develop actionable strategies. So the whole thing, now they are good at it. Say here, we talked about organic farming. I was into organic farming, Vedic farming, Homa farming, biodynamic farming, and all whole lot. The ultimate point is what we do in the name of agriculture should not disturb the ecology, should not disturb the environment, and the produce would not carry any of the residual toxicity. That's the end of it. The mode may be different, name may be different, anything. So the precision farming system is not the list there, it is in Dharmavari. Where out of 4.5 lakhs a hectare, only irrigation is available only for 4,000 hectares. It's the driest land. The farmers are about to move out of this land. Around the year, now he is happy. The water usage is minimized. Not there. And timely operations. And then calculated quantity of inputs, not a kilo in excess. And the timing of the spray, if you really adopt it, ultimately the end produce, the residual toxicity problem will not be there. Cost of it, just cost. Can you imagine 1.15 acre, 170 metric tons, 8.5 lakhs years here, and then your water screen cut your. It was a bridge of Scorpio. Next. Say, the bridge all the company did not know, the scientist we did not know, that bridge all can be maintained for 1 year, 3 months. It is a 6 months crop. The farmer did it. So compared to what you have taken to the farmers in the name of technology, what you have learned by living with them for 3 years, it was much more. So we have passed on so many issues to the research community, so many issues to the academic community, so many issues to the extension community. Say the bottom leaf, you see the fruit and the flower at the top. After 1 year, how come the lower leaves are not withering and yellowing and then dropping? Actually, scientists will have to do the reverse engineering to scientifically validate how this could happen. Even the company, the Angus seeds, they have hiked the rate of seeds from 25,000 to 35,000 rupees on completion of the corporate gain. That means, my point here is, the traditional wisdom, the generational wisdom trickled down through the generations, it is much more vital than the generated wisdom of institutions. Things logic is simple, sir. To the extent I spend for the crop, I spend for the soil. The soil is not an enough material. It is as dynamic as you are. What we eat, we get, things get digested. The same way, anything you put into soil, it gets digested. You respire, the soil also respire. Aerobic and anaerobic. You reproduce, the same way. Whether seed or twig or anything you put, it regenerates. It's a very living, dynamic entity. As a layman, he simply says, to the extent I care for the crop, I care for the soil. He is the president of the limited company, Education is for the Son. So, Tarapalli, Rajas' birthplace, when I entered into the village, how corrupt the rural setting was. This is an indication. With all sincerity, we gained entry into the village and talked to 20 or 25 people in the evening. And next day morning, Tarapalli. Next day morning, sir, we agreed. Provided, if you don't get that yield, we will sue you in the court, number one. If you don't get the assured yield, we will catch hold of your jeep and we will not release. If we don't get the yield, we will catch all your senior research fellows and lock it in the bottle. These are all the three conditions they have. Now they have become spokesmen for us. So water is not that much. So the social capital matters. So since from the first 5 year plan up to 11th 5 year plan, the money was dumped in for R&D. And for extension, every state is spending nearly 1,000 crores for the extension mechanism. And not for the capacity building of the farmers. Only the technical training we give, not the managerial training. The managerial capital, the farmers, the social capital will have to be carried. How to manage the farm resources, how to generate more resources, how to spend, how to make use of the inputs, how to make use of the technology. The input use efficiency and technology use efficiency both are much more in the system. So ultimately, more than the inputs, more than the technology, it was the way we dealt with the social capital that put this program on the success map. Next. The individual slide itself is a story for the time being. The crop is immaterial. The input is immaterial. What matters is the farmers. Now, in one or two places, one, say hardly five or six examples, how to take it further? How to scale it up? If we leave it at this stage, hardly few more will come as long as university pushes it. Once after some time, then naturally it will get managed. I have given another program called participatory farm. Here, 100 hectares of land the farmers will have to offer. It is only the voluntary, the university will call the expression of interest. Those interested farmers having 100 hectares in full, there may be a colony, there may be a well, there may be a community hall, there may be anything, but no farmer inside alone. Let us consolidate the land on the third stage. Say, let us consolidate the land and then issue share certificates by incorporating the producer company. Let the farmers lease the company, they lease the land to the company, to the portion of the assets they have given to the company, let them get the shares. That means lesser and lessee are the same. The asset is not disturbed. If they want to give their land to sons and daughters, they can simply give the share certificate. The advantage is, say there is a going to be board of directors, 10 people, then four of us, you please come with us. From the university, we two people will join. Let six people take care of the day-to-day activity. Go for 50% three crops, another 20% one-year crop like banana, your turmeric or tapioca, then 20% annual crops. Then, other than crop enterprise, we introduce animal husband enterprise, fishery enterprise, and then farm eco-tourism. Let the family come and spend. Don't provide luxurious guest house or other amenities. It is a rustic hut. It is a farmer's living. Those who ever want to be with the farm and involve in farming activities and get to know, get close to the nature and they enjoy the harmony with the nature, let them come. That kind of tourism let us develop. And that adds another value system. So, over the years, the land value gets enhanced. In the third year, the dividend can flow into the farmer because today it is levelless, tomorrow it is ownerless. What we reckon is only 3 crores, not as a goal. 1.5 crores you will repay it at the end of fourth year, and another 1.5 crore that will be equity in the company, you can put an officer inside. I think one among the 10 you cannot do any damage. So, this program we have given it to the planning commission, if it comes through, the expression of interest will be gone, and at least two models let us demonstrate, and across the state, all the 30 districts let us have the such kind of development, and then leave it to the social corporate responsibility of the corporate, let them invest. If we don't do this, multinationals will come in, FDA will come in, engulfing 10,000, 20,000 hectares. This is not the only option I say, it's one of the options. Born out of our experience with the precision farming, born out of our experience with organic farming, born out of our experience with these institutional mechanisms, and born out of our own indigenous wisdom that is already available with the farmers. So, this kind of participatory farming, it will not take the right away from the farmers. That is the crux of this thing. The right of the farmers is restored. The farmers, those who have come out, they can do the work in the farm, or they can collectively produce some inputs and then supply to the farm, or they can pursue some small business, or they can simply relax. There is an exit policy. The whole thing is just in the project part. So this is our next plan to keep the social capital, the farmers' economy on the vibrant side. All other services, all other reliance on to the government, reliance on to the other mechanisms will not happen. We let empower the farmers with their support and just let us act as representative. So that's the end of it. Any queries? Please.
Sir, you mentioned in the context of the Theni banana growers that they were earlier cultivating about 17 different varieties. And for the sake of standardization, you brought it down to one. Now, when you travel abroad, one of the things which strikes anybody from this part of the world is that the lack of sheer variety. You go to even a place like Singapore, you'll get only one type of banana. One size, one type, period. Whereas you travel every second kilometer, you'll get a different. Now, is such sacrifice of diversity, sacrifice of that sort of gene bank, is that a precondition for these models to succeed, or is it a price that one has to necessarily pay? Because these are very inspiring models.
Your concern and understand, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
This Trichy is the belt wherein almost 25 varieties of banana are being grown. Length and breadth of the state, everywhere we cannot do this. Only in selected places we can go with one or two varieties. So all other rest of the varieties, they have one way or other, they have some shortcomings in terms of shelf life, in terms of prone to pests and diseases. So they are all locally consumed. If you want your market boundary outside the state, in some areas we will have to go with one or two varieties.
So what you are saying is, we have to sacrifice some amount of diversity because that is how the model will
come. I don't think it's not a sacrifice, sir, but suppose if I plan for the entire state, it is a sacrifice. I don't plan for the state. Even the red banana, it can be promoted as a horseman food. The main food, it can be promoted as a baby food. So that way, ultimately the farmer's income as well as the biodiversity, both are important. Plan is not to come in the world.
Thank you,
Professor. I am Kamal Rai from